Deep in the heart of Antarctica, there lies a mystery that has puzzled scientists for decades. The Blood Falls, a red waterfall that flows from the Taylor Glacier, has long been a source of intrigue and speculation. But what is the cause for this strange phenomenon? Welcome to Facts Insight. For more videos such as this one, please visit this channel for insights based solely on facts. Make sure to subscribe and give a like. Now let's take a closer look at the history and the science behind the Blood Falls. In Victoria Land, East Antarctica, a waterfall known as Blood Falls gushes out of the Taylor Glacier. The daring explorers who were able to reach this remote valley were confused for years by this unexpected sight. Although we now have a clear understanding of what is driving this horrifying occurrence, research conducted over the past few decades has shown this small area of Antarctica may be even stranger than we previously thought. A person made the initial discovery of this blood fall in 1911. During the expedition period, Thomas Griffith Taylor, an Australian explorer, served as the expedition leader. Despite the fact that the British National Arctic Expedition several years ago made a note of this glacier, nonetheless, it was regarded as a piece of the Farrar Glacier. The Taylor expedition did, however, find the two glaciers were connected to one another. They made the decision to name the new one after their captain as a result. After some time, the same group discovered that the glacier appeared to be oozing blood-colored, rust-colored water from its snout. Taylor and his team originally thought that the red algae were to blame for the vibrant colors. Soon after all of this, researchers started looking for explanations for these anomalous parts. Blood Falls, named for its ruddy color, is not in fact a gush of blood for some unseen wound. The falls flow out of Taylor Glacier in Antarctica's McMurdo Dry Valleys, and the water bubbles up from fissures in the glacier's top. The average temperature is 1.4 degrees Fahrenheit, negative 17 Celsius. The little glacial melting is visible at the surface. Therefore, the flow was previously a mystery. But the study also argues that the brine's chemical composition explains why it flows rather than freezes. According to the study, the higher salt content and latent heat of freezing allow the brine to remain liquid in subglacial and inglacial conditions. Usually, salty water can be found in the glacier's lake. Salty water melts the ice and allows the river to flow. Because it has a low freezing point than pure water and loses heat when it freezes, this implies that the coldest glacier on Earth can sustain continuously flowing iron-rich water that resembles blood due to its red color. The study also counts how much iron-rich brine is present in the river, and it discovers the amount of brine rises as measurements go closer to the fall. Thus, it was discovered that there was a correlation between water temperature and salt content, because the glacier's fissure of various sizes allowed brine to enter. The concentration of brine in the center of the fissure rises as the brine starts to freeze, and the latent heat warms the ice surrounding it. The concentration of brine in the center of the cracks increase. The outpour from blood falls may serve as a time glacier from a period when our world was quite different from how it is now, because the water has been trapped beneath the glacier for millions of years. According to a 2009 research, the blood falls system and its peculiar microbial inhabitants may be able to shed light on how life on Earth endured when the entire planet was frozen over. As during the postulated snowball Earth, it might also provide some insight into the potential existence of life on other planets, like Mars and Jupiter's moon, Europa, which have subglacial bodies of frozen water. This salty liquid, which is yet to be found, is chemically comparable to salt water. But despite the absence of oxygen, the extreme cold, and the lack of light, this water beneath the inside Antarctic glacier appeared to maintain uncommon microbial life, which goes against what scientists had previously thought. The discharge from beneath the Taylor Glacier, an outlet glacier in the McMurdo Dry Valley, was properly analyzed and sampled. After then, scientists thought it wasn't enough light for the photosynthesis process to produce food. These microorganisms have evolved to rely on iron and sulfur compounds to stay alive over the course of millions of years. They were able to determine that the population beneath the glacier is made up of remnants of highly populated bacteria that originally inhabited this area, thanks to the microbes' striking resemblance to other natural species in the marine environment. Additionally, those liquid lakes that were locked kilometers beneath the Antarctic ice sheets were unfathomable to a scientist as a source of life for those living things. It would be accurate to state, but these riddles always appear to leave us with one unanswered question. An old saltwater lake was allegedly present right here when the Taylor Glacier was approaching about 2 million years ago, during the so-called Snowball Earth Epoch. Also, there are numerous issues that have baffled scientists for a very long period. First of all, there are no external oxygen source in the water deep under the glacier, which is estimated to be 400 meters below the surface. This contributes to the anoxic environment that exists today. It is unusual for ferrous iron and sulfate ions to coexist under such circumstances. They thus assume that metabolic cycles involve the combination of iron and sulfur. Science still has a lot to learn about how these strange things may exist in a place like Blodfoss. The research published in the Journal of Glaciology could help give scientists a better understanding of the hydrological world beneath glaciers. Now you know the mysteries about the mystery of Antarctica's Blodfoss. Let us know in the comments below what you think about it. Make sure to like and subscribe to our channel to get the latest updates. Thank you for watching and see you soon in the next video.